Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another Dicon Dissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today, we're going to be reacting to Ring of Fire by Johnny Cash. Before we get into it, let me just say, I've heard this song before. And a lot of people under my recent reaction to Home Free were requesting that I do this song by Home Free. But I wanted to go back to the original first, because I don't think I've ever really taken a close look at the lyrics. And the last time I heard this song was in the movie Walk the Line, I think. Almost positive they played this song in that movie, which I watched with my mom a little over a year ago. It was a while ago. But anyway, so here we are. Johnny Cash, a phenomenal player who's very inspirational because, you know, he... people kind of told him that he didn't know how to sing and whatnot, and he kind of created his own style of both guitar playing and singing, and got, you know, famous for it and was able to bring his message to lots of people because of it. His life story is very crazy and interesting. And yeah, I like Johnny Cash. So that being said, here we go. Ring of Fire by Johnny Cash. If you're new to the channel, hello, my name is Daniel. Here we react to music, and I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally. Normally, it's the things I've never heard before, but in this case, no. But we always do research after we listen to the song. And if you like these types of videos, consider subscribing if you want. And here we go. Ring of Fire by Johnny Cash. Thanks for joining me. Let's go. I forgot about the horns in the song.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. Fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. But the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
The ring of fire. Yeah, okay. This is Johnny Cash's Ring of Fire. Soon to be second wife, June Carter wrote Ring of Fire in 1963 with Merle Kilgore to express the experience of falling in love with the married man in black. And Cash would continue to walk the line with his first wife, Vivian Liberto, until 1966. June Carter finally became June Carter Cash in 1968. After being originally recorded by June's sister Anita Carter as Love's Ring of Fire, the song was recorded by Cash on March 25th, 1963. It became the biggest hit of his... Really? This is the biggest hit of Johnny Cash's career? Did not know that. Staying at number one on the charts for 7 weeks, it was certified gold on January 21st, 2010 by the RIAA, and has also sold over 1.2 million digital downloads. Damn. In 2002, shortly before his death, he sang another cover, Hurt, the perfect bookend to Ring of Fire. In it, he acknowledges his failures as a husband and a friend. If Ring of Fire was the first warning sign of obsessive compulsive personality, Hurt is the final apology. All right. Bethesda used a cover of this song for its Fallout 76 thing. Okay, cool. So Bethesda used a cover of this song in the trailer for its worst game. That's exciting. It's not its worst game, but still, worst Fallout game, in my opinion. All right, not that that's important. Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. And in this first verse, the protagonist describes what love is like, describing the feeling of desire as if you yourself were on fire. June Carter wrote Ring of Fire early on in her relationship with Johnny Cash, while they were both married to others. It was a tough time for her because she was already married, and because she knew what kind of person Cash was even as she was falling in love with him. She once wrote this about the song. There is no way to be in that kind of hell. No way to extinguish a flame that burns, burns, burns. Johnny Cash compared love to a ring of fire, saying they both excite and torment the victim. And the longer you stay in a relationship, the more intense the flames become. That sentiment's the exact opposite of The Thrill Is Gone. Huh. Although many believe Ring of Fire to be about falling in love, Johnny Cash's first wife, Vivian Liberto, offers a different perspective. In her book, I Walked the Line, she contends that June didn't co-write the song as credited. To this day, it confounds me to hear the elaborate details June told of writing that song for Johnny. She didn't write that song any more than I did. The truth is, Johnny wrote that song while pilled up and drunk about a certain private female body part. All these years of her claiming she wrote it herself, and she probably never knew what the song was really about. And the comments beneath that are interesting. That's an interesting perspective, and yeah, I have no idea what the answer is, just so you know. Johnny, like many other lovers, knows how delicious love can be when fully corresponded. Taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. Johnny Cash and June Carter were ready for such a love, and its fruition is reminiscent of ripened fruit. Once in a while, like today, I meditate on it and realize how lucky I am to share my life with the greatest woman I ever met. Cash wrote in a birthday letter to June, "You're the object of my desire, the number one earthly reason for my existence." Strong words. Yeah, wow, that's it. This is a short video, but I love this song. I thought I loved this song. Don't know why I didn't remember the horn section, but whatever. Let's see. God bless the man who made the lyrics in images so blind people can listen to the song. It's got way more likes than it should have, and to all the people commenting, "You mean deaf, that is the joke." Ah, yeah. See, I saw that the whatever this video was started to have lots of images, like random images, and I just moved off it because of that. Because, I don't know, those are distracting, especially when it's not like an official music video or something the artist intended, or like a lyric video, then it's just like, I don't know. For me personally, it's distracting. Yeah. One of Johnny Cash's biggest hits. It's a really great song by him. My grandpa made us play this song at his funeral. He was getting cremated. No. That's probably not a good reaction to that comment, but still. Well played. This is an awesome video montage. Okay. A lot of the comments are about the music video itself. Loved it. Johnny Cash nailed it when country music meets with mariachi horns. What a fantastic idea. The early 60s country music scene was blown away with the song and approach. What an explosive time it was for the development of what we know today as classic country. And it's amazing that Johnny was right there with the fantastic contributions to the era. This song still sounds great at my own live gigs pre-COVID, and it works well on the cruise ship gigs as well. People love it. My students love to learn and play this song as well. If you need it transposed into a different key to make it easier to sing, I can help you with that as well. Gotta love the classics. Thanks for posting this video. Wow, teacher. That's cool. All right. Well, in the shuffling madness, we're going to have to say goodbye. Until next time, stay tuned for the Home Free reaction to their a cappella cover of this song. I think with a member of Pentatonix as well, which is pretty cool. But yeah, love Johnny Cash. And thank you for joining me. I'll see you guys soon. Deathstroke 9, out.